The previous class we discussed on formulation of LPP. In today's class we will be discussing how to solve the linear programming problem graphically. Solve graphically. Maximize z is equal to 60x plus 15y subject to constraints x plus y less than or equal to 50, 3x plus y less than or equal to 90, xy greater than or equal to 0. Solution. Consider the inequations x plus y less than or equal to 50, 3x plus y less than or equal to 90, and convert to equations, that is x plus y is equal to 50, 3x plus y is equal to 90. Consider x, y. So when x is equal to 0, y is equal to 50. So when you put y is equal to 0 in this equation, x is equal to 50. So in the second equation, so when you put x is equal to 0, y is equal to 90. When you put y is equal to 0, x is equal to 3x is equal to 90, you'll get. So x is equal to 90 by 3, that is equal to 30. So the coordinates will be 0, 50, 50, 0. And here it is 0, 90, then 30, 0. So now write on the scale on the graph sheet. Scale is along x-axis. Since you have two-digit numbers here, so 90, 30, 50, so along x-axis, I'll consider 1 centimeter is equal to 10 units. And along y-axis, I'll consider each division, that is 1 centimeter is equal to 10 units. You should write the scale. So now I will write on this as 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80 goes, 90. Same way, this side. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, so 90, so 100 goes this way. So I consider the first quadrant here because here x and y both are greater than or equal to 0. Now consider the line equation x plus y is equal to 50. In this, the coordinates are 0, 50, 50, 0. So 0, 50, so mark a point here. Okay, 0, 50 is here. And 50, 0. 50, 0, it is on the x-axis. So now, you draw the line. So 50, 0, 50, 50, 0. Join the line. The next is 0, 90, 30, 0. For the line 3x plus y is equal to 90, 0, 90, 30, 0. 0, 90 comes here on the y-axis. 0, 90 is here. 0, 90. 30, 0. 30, 0 on the x-axis. 30, 0 is on the x-axis. So now you join these two points, that is draw the line from here, join these two points.
Yes.
So now you should shade the region to find out the feasible region. So here, when you consider both these lines, x plus y is less than or equal to 50 and 3x plus y less than or equal to 90. Therefore, in both the lines, when you consider the region, you mark will be downwards towards the origin. And here also towards the origin. So from both the lines, in this region, there is a overlapping. There is a overlapping from these two regions. Okay. So therefore, this region, we call it as feasible region. So this region, we call it as feasible region. So this, you have to shade it properly. This region, you call it as feasible region. Shade it properly. So now, write down this as A. A 0, 50, and this point of intersection, this is 20, this is 30. So that point I'll consider it as B is 20, 30, and this point I'll consider it as C, that is 30, 0. So now you should find the values of Z at these corner points. This you should consider it as feasible region. So just write down it as feasible region. So now you consider the values of Z for this. So when you consider the values for Z, if you write it in table, it looks neat. Okay, so now corner points and corresponding value of Z. So that is Z is equal to 60x plus 15y. So consider this bounded region, that is OCBA. So at the origin 0, 0. So what is Z value? Z value will be 0. 60 into 0 plus 50 into 0, it will become 0. And at the point A 0, 50. So at the point A 0, 50. So Z is equal to 60 into 0 is 0 plus 15 into 50, that is equal to 750. And at the point B, 20, 30. So at the point B, 20, 30. So Z value is equal to 60 into 20 plus 15 into 30. So that is equal to 1200 plus 450 is equal to 1650. And next point is C. C 30 comma 0. C 30 comma 0, Z is equal to 60 into 30 plus 0 into 15 is 0. So 60 into 30, the answer is 1800. So when you consider all these four points, for which one the Z value is maximum, you should see. So at the point 30 comma 0, Z value is maximum, that is equal to 1800. So this value is the maximum value for Z. So the optimal solution is obtained when X is equal to 30, Y is equal to 0. So therefore, Z maximum is equal to 1800 at X is equal to 30, Y is equal to 0. So I'll repeat once again. They have asked you to maximize, that is Z is equal to 60X plus 15Y subject to the constraints X plus Y less than or equal to 50, 3X plus Y less than or equal to 90, XY greater than or equal to 0. You should solve it graphically. So consider these inequations, that is X plus Y less than or equal to 50, 3X plus Y less than or equal to 90, convert into equations. X plus Y is equal to 50, 3X plus Y is equal to 90. So find the coordinates of the x-intercept and y-intercept. So xy, when x is equal to 0, y is equal to 50. When y is equal to 0, x is equal to 50. So the coordinates will be 0, 50, 50, 0. And when you consider this line, it is when x is equal to 0, y is equal to 90. When y is equal to 0, x is equal to 30. So the coordinates are 0, 90, 30, comma 0. So the corner points, so it is 0, 0, 0, 50, 20, 30, 30, 0. So I got it by plotting the points and joining the lines this way. So here first I took 0, 50, 50, 0. So I joined the line. That is, this line is X plus Y is equal to 50. And the next line, 0, 90, 30, 0. So I joined this, and this line is 3x plus y is equal to 90. So since these two inequalities is less than or equal to 0, it is towards the origin. And the feasible region will be in the first quadrant because x and y is greater than or equal to 0. So therefore, from both the lines, the region, in this region, there is the overlapping. Therefore, this region is considered as feasible region, that is OCBA. And mark the points, consider the corner points and the value of Z to find the maximum value of Z. So at 30 comma 0, you'll be getting the maximum value, that is 1800. So at 0 comma 0, you're getting 0, 0 comma 50, 750, 20 comma 30, you're getting 1650. At 30 comma 0, you're getting 1800. Therefore, Z maximum is equal to 1800 at X is equal to 30, Y is equal to 0. And this point of intersection 20, 30, you can also find by solving these two simultaneous equations by any method, elimination or substitution method, whichever you like. Okay. Yes. Or else you can just see this graph. So where this line and when you see this line meets, so there it is 20, 30. First you write x coordinate, then y coordinate. Yes, write on this. So we'll go to next question. Solve graphically maximize z is equal to 60x plus 40y subject to constraints 2x plus y less than or equal to 60, x is less than or equal to 25, y is less than or equal to 35, xy greater than or equal to 0. So here the first step is I'll change this inequalities to equation 2x plus y is equal to 60. So x, y, when x is equal to 0, y is equal to 60. When y is equal to 0, 2x is equal to 60. So x is equal to 30. So therefore, the coordinates will be 0, 60, then 30, comma 0. So this one, x is less than or equal to 25. I can just take it as x is equal to 25. So the coordinates on the x-axis will be 25 comma 0. And the third one, it is y less than or equal to 35. Write it as y is equal to 35. The coordinates will be on the y-axis. So it is 0 comma 35. So now we should plot the graph. So write down the x-axis and y-axis. So you should write down the x-axis and y-axis. So write down x-axis and y-axis. So x-axis, y-axis, origin, and you should write the scale. So scale is along x-axis 1 centimeter is equal to 10 units because you have 10, 20, 30, 25, 2-digit numbers. So along y-axis, I'll consider 1 centimeter is equal to again 10 units. So I'll mark it as 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, so 90 it goes, and here 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100. So now the point is 0, 60, 30, 0. 0, 60, it comes here, so mark it here, 0, 60. 30, 0 on the x-axis, 30, 0. So now, draw the line, 0, 60, 30, 0. So 0, 60, 30, 0. So join the line. So next is x is equal to 25. So x is equal to 25 is a line parallel to y-axis. X is equal to 25. This point comes here, 25, between 20 and 30. So is the line parallel to y-axis. X is equal to k is the line parallel to y-axis. Y is equal to k is the line parallel to x-axis. So I have studied this the last year. So write down the, draw the straight line. Y is equal to 35. Y is equal to 35. Point comes here. So therefore, it is a line parallel to x-axis. Line parallel to x-axis. Draw the line this way. So now you should find the feasible region. So when you consider the feasible region here, so from this the region goes this way, and from this here in this region, from all the lines in this region, it will overlap. This region it will overlap. So therefore, this is your feasible region. This is your feasible region. So you can shade it or draw the lines, however, but you should mark the feasible region. So this is your feasible region. So what are the corner points? So corner points, origin 0, 0, and this point is 25, 0. So that is 25, 0. I'll call this as A. So 25, 0, I'll call this as A. And this point, it is 10. 25, 10. This point is 25, 10. I'll call this as B. So here you can check, this is 25 and this point it will be 10. And here this point it comes somewhere around in between this. This is still 15, in between this 10 and 15 it comes. So it is 12.5. C, I can mark this as C, 12.535. 12.5, 35. So and this point I'll mark it as D. So this is 0, 35. So first you mark the x coordinate, then y coordinate. Okay, this is 25, 10. So now you write down the table for the corner point and the values of Z. So you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 points. One, two, three, four, five points. So now corner points, corner points and value of z. So what is that equation? Z is equal to 60x plus 40y. So at the origin 0, 0. So z value is equal to 60 into 0 plus 40 into 0, it is 0. And at the point A 25, 0. So z is equal to, it is 60 into 25 plus 0. So 25 into 6, 25, 0, 25 into 6. So it is 1500. And the next point is B, 25, 10. So z is equal to, so 60 into 25 plus 40 into 10. So that value will be equal to 1500 plus 400. So you'll be getting 1900. So the next is C, 12.5, 35. So z is equal to 60 into 12.5 plus 40 into 35. So you'll be getting 750 plus 1400. So 2150. So at the point D, 0, 35. So z value is equal to, z value is equal to 60 into 0, that is 0, plus 40 into 35. So we'll be getting 1400. So for which value it is maximum? So it is maximum at 12.535, and the maximum value is 2150. So the optimal solution is obtained when x is equal to 12.5 and y is equal to 35. So therefore you should write z maximum is equal to 2150 at x is equal to 12.5, y is equal to 35. So for the graph, you'll get 3 marks, and writing this and the conclusion carries 2 marks. If you miss conclusion, you lose 1 mark. So conclusion is compulsory. So write in simple terms, that is that maximum is equal to 2150 at x is equal to 12.5, y is equal to 35. And compulsorily you should mark the feasible region. In case you don't mark the feasible region, again you lose 1 mark. So be careful. So try to get complete 5 marks. Yes, write down. The question is, solve graphically minimize z is equal to 2x plus 3y subject to constraints x plus y greater than or equal to 350, 2x plus y less than or equal to 600, xy greater than or equal to 0. Here you have greater than or equal to and less than or equal to, so both. So you should be a little careful. The first step is you'll be converting the inequalities, linear inequalities to equations, inequations to equation. So for that, you should find the x-intercept and y-intercept. So finding the x-intercept and y-intercept. So x plus y is equal to 350. So x, y, when x is equal to 0, y is equal to 350. When y is equal to 0, x is equal to 350. Same way, 2x plus y is equal to 600, xy. When x is equal to 0, y is equal to 600. When y is equal to 0, 2x is equal to 600, so x is equal to 300. So write the coordinates. Coordinates will be 0, 350. This is 350, 0. And here it is 0, 600, 300, 0. So now, so draw the graph, x-axis, y-axis, scale. X, y-axis. X-axis. So this is x-axis, y-axis, origin, scale. Scale along x-axis, along x-axis, 1 centimeter is equal to, I will take 100 units. Here it is 3-digit numbers. So what I do is I will take 100 units. 100 units. And y-axis, I will take 1 centimeter is equal to again 100 units. So I'll write on this as 100, 200, 300, 400, 500, 600, 700, 800. Same way, here 100, 200, 300, 400, 500, 600, 700, 800, 900, okay, it goes, 1000 it goes. So now 0, 350, 0, 350, 0, 350, it comes here on the y-axis in between 300 and 400. 350, 0, 350, 0. So 350, 0, again here. 350, 0. So now you join those two points, draw the line, join those two points, draw the line. Yes. So now you mark the other points, that is for the other line 0, 600, 300, 0. 0, 600. 0, 600, 300, 0. 300, 0 is here somewhere. Okay. So now 300, 0, 600, 0, 600, 300, 0. So now you draw the line. 600 0 600 300 0 0 600 300 0. So draw the line. So now you should mark the feasible region, shading of the feasible region. So you should be very careful here, because one of the line linear inequality, it is x plus y greater than or equal to 350, other one less than or equal to 600. So both the region overlap in this. So one is x plus y greater than or equal to 350. Greater than or equal to 350, it goes this way. So, and less than or equal to, so downwards towards the origin. So therefore, your feasible region, the region where both the lines overlap, is this. This region. In this region, so it's overlapping. So this will be your feasible region. So your feasible region is this. So this, I'll mark this as A 0, 600, and this is B, the point of intersection. You can just find out this point. This point is, it comes around 250, 100. So otherwise, you can solve these two simultaneous equations and get the value of x and y. That will be the point of intersection. That way also it is possible. So it is 250, 100. First you write x coordinate, then y coordinate. So then A, B, C. So this I'll mark it as C. C is 0, 350. 0, 350. So this is feasible region. So this is your feasible region. So always mark the feasible region and write down. So now you should find the corresponding values of Z for these three corner points. So write it in the tabular form, so that the data looks neat. So here, corner points and corresponding value of Z. So what is Z? Z is equal to 2x plus 3y. So that you can write down. So first point is A 0, 600. So when you substitute 0, 600, I'll be getting 0 plus 3 into 600. So it is 1800. Then B, (250, 100). So 250, 100. So I'll be getting Z is equal to 2 × 250 + 3 × 100. So that is equal to, so we'll be getting it as 500 + 300. That is equal to 800. 250 × 2 = 500. Plus 3 × 100 = 300. 500 + 300 = 800. Then C 0, 350. So that is equal to 0 + 3 × 350. That is equal to 1050. 15, 9, 10. So 1050. So for which value it is minimum here? Because it is minimized. It is to minimize. So when they are asked to minimize, see the minimum value. Minimum value is 800. So you got minimum value is 800 at the point 250, 100. So the optimal solution is obtained when x is equal to 250, y is equal to 100. So therefore, z minimum is equal to 800 at x is equal to 250, y is equal to 100. So this is how you'll be solving graphically. So in case of maximizing, you'll be checking the maximum value. In case of minimizing, you'll be checking minimum value. So you should be little careful while taking the values. Minimize So again, solve graphically. So minimize z is equal to 3x plus 5y subject to constraints, x plus 3y greater than or equal to 3, x plus y greater than or equal to 2, xy greater than or equal to 0. So solution, same way, consider these two inequations and convert it to equations. So for that, so I'll take two tables. So x plus 3y is equal to 3. So x, y, when x is equal to 0, 3y is equal to 3, so y is equal to 1. When y is equal to 0, x is equal to 3. Same way, the second constraint, x plus y is equal to 2. So in this case, x, y, when x is equal to 0, y is equal to 2. When y is equal to 0, x is equal to 2. So the coordinates here will be 0, 1, 3, 0. And here it is 0, 2, 2, 0. So now graph. So we'll be drawing the x-axis and y-axis. So mark x-axis and y-axis, origin O. So along x-axis scale, so I got 1, 2, 3 here. So I can just take x-axis, 1 centimeter is equal to 1 unit. Y-axis, 1 centimeter is equal to 1 unit. So I'll mark this as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So again, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So 0 comma 1, so it is marked here, and 3 comma 0, 3 comma 0 marked here. So now draw the line 0 comma 1, 3 comma 0. Yes. The next equation, x plus y is equal to 2, 0 comma 2, 2 comma 0. So 0 comma 2 comes here, then 2 comma 0 comes here. So now draw the line 0 comma 2. Okay, so now here you should mark the feasible region. So feasible region, since it is greater than or equal to, it goes away from the origin. So here, where both the regions from both the lines meet is this. This is your feasible region. So therefore, this is an unbounded region. So in the previous one, it was bounded region. You had a boundary, proper boundary. But here, this is an unbounded region, unbounded feasible region. So this is your feasible region. So now, when you get an unbounded feasible region, so the corner points will be these three points. So this point, it will be, so it is 1.5, 0.5. So this point is, what is that point? 1.5, 0.5. So here it is 0.5, 1.5. So write on the corner points. Corner points will be 3, 0, then 1.5, 0.5, then 0, 2. So this I'll mark it as A, 3, 0, this B, this point I'll mark it as B, 1.5, 0.5, then this point is C, 0, 2. So now calculate the value of Z. Three points. So corner points, value of Z. What is that? Z is equal to 3x plus 5y. So the corner points here, A, 3, 0. So Z value is 3 into 3, 9. And B, 1.5, 0.5. So Z value is equal to 3 into 1.5 plus 5 into 0.5. So that value is 4.5. 1.5 into 3, 4.5 plus 5 into 0.5, 2.5, that is equal to 7. And the last C, 0, 2. So 2 into 0 into 3 plus 5 into 2. So Z is equal to 5 into 3 into 0 plus 5 into 2. So that is equal to 10. So for this point, that is B 1.5, 0.5, the value of Z is minimum, that is 7. You should consider one more line, that is 3x plus 5y less than 7. So less than 7. So for this, you should consider one more dotted line, because this is strictly less than. Therefore, when x is 0, I'll be getting y as 1.4, and 1.4, around 1.4 I get. And when y is 0, I'll be getting x as around 2.3. So it around comes here. Okay, so that passes through the point of intersection. Okay, so 1.5, 0.5. So, but the region here is, since this is less than 7, so the region you mark is downwards. And here, these two regions, it will not overlap. This region will not overlap with this. And therefore, the line represented by this, okay, the graph represented by 3x plus 5y less than 7, has no points common with the feasible region. Therefore, Z minimum is 7 at the point 1.5, 0.5. Consider the line, so which shows it has no points common with the feasible region. So therefore Z minimum is equal to 7 at x is equal to 1.5, y is equal to 0.5. Okay, so again, all these questions ask for 5 marks in part D. So practice each and every step properly. Draw the graph neatly, mark the feasible region, write the scale. Okay, so don't forget any steps. So please write all the steps carefully. So I'll repeat once again, what are the steps? First step, what you do? So you'll be converting the linear inequations to equation and finding the coordinates of x and y intercept, and you plot the points on the graph. Graph sheet will be provided for you in the examination. So just draw the lines and mark the feasible region, and then corner points, value of Z, and then you find out if it is maximized, find out the maximum value of Z. If it is minimized, find out the minimum value of Z. So by this, we have come to the end of the chapter. Thank you.